Oxycontin abuse in Southwest Florida may be decreasing because of a tamper-proof pill. It makes it nearly impossible to abuse the drug. But there's a new problem. Many people who need it can't get it. NBC2's Dave Elias discovered state legislators are now getting involved. Dave?
Yeah, Peter, take a look at this video. This Oxycontin pill is so tamper-proof that a sledgehammer can't even break it up. It's just that tough. Now, that makes it so that it cannot be snorted and it can't be dissolved either. There's just one problem. Many people who legitimately need it for pain can't get it, and now one state legislator is working to change that.
I was deterred at first because of the expensive price that I would have to pay to get them.
He's talking about these Oxycontin pills that can't even be crushed with a pair of pliers.
It's extremely challenging to break these tablets because they're so hard,
making it nearly impossible for a drug abuser to crush it and snort it. Pharmacists like Rich Lawrence say the reformulated pill has cut down on the abuse, but the new pill is terribly expensive.
And oftentimes insurance companies won't want to pay for it. They will have cheaper alternatives.
Many of the alternatives are abusable pills, meaning they can be crushed to snort or inject.
And then it requires the prescriber and the patient oftentimes to jump through hoops to get the approval for that medication.
State Representative Elizabeth Benacquisto wants to eliminate those hoops.
When folks can't get access to it, that's difficult.
She's introduced a bill that would require all insurance companies to pay for the tamper-proof Oxycontin when doctors prescribe it for fear their patients may abuse a cheaper pill.
When the medication is left over or someone takes it from their house, it won't be able to be abused again in a way that it was not prescribed for.
And making it less likely to be sold on the streets.
Originally, I believe that they were paying $80 per pill.
Now, so far, the bill has passed all of the committees and a vote in the Senate. Elizabeth Benacquisto says that she's confident that it will have the support, Peter, it needs to make it become a law.
All right, so these tamper-proof pills, they cut down on people using the pills, but a lot of people then turn to heroin. Does Benacquisto address that problem?
You know, I ask her about that question. She says that that is very important, and she says that legislators actually need to spend more money for substance abuse treatment in order to deal with the problem.
Thanks, Dave.
Mm-hmm.